Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy, and tonight I have the energy to film a video, which is really great. I'm very happy about that. So I'm going to be talking about a topic that some people have asked me in past to film on, and actually somebody asked me in a recent question and answer video that I did, and that is my biggest hamster mistakes. So no pet owner is perfect and everybody makes mistakes, and when I started owning hamsters many years ago, I was still a kid and there was not a whole lot of research at the time that had been done on hamsters. Now I did do my best to go research and I went to the library so many times and I pulled out like every single hamster book that you can imagine. But the problem is that all of these books were giving information that as of now we know is wrong. So I followed the advice in these books, and now that I look back on it, it's not a very good thing. So I'm going to start off with the housing. So sadly, my first two hamsters both lived in unsuitable cages that were too small. S'mores actually had it better. He was my first hamster, and he lived in it was basically a bunch of habitrail type of tubes connected to various little square cages, and then there was a 10-gallon aquarium, and he would chew a lot in his cage at night, and we always thought he was just, you know, like that's just a hamster thing, they chew, but we didn't realize that he was chewing because he most likely needed more space, so I feel really bad about that. Tin Roof Sunday was my second hamster, and again, I was going based off of my past research. I housed him in a 10-gallon aquarium with pine and cedar bedding, which I feel so bad about. The good thing is that Tin Roof lived to be 3.5 years old, and S'mores lived to be 2.5 years old, so I don't think that's too bad considering. Another one of the mistakes that I've made, which I've actually mentioned this in my question and answer video as well, is I have accidentally left bubble caps off of my cages before. I've gotten distracted when I was cleaning. I do have a really bad story, and this is the story that I'm most embarrassed about. This is probably my biggest hamster mistake. So there was a period of time where I had Cream Puff, and then I started adopting a bunch of other hamsters, and at this point I believe I had it was either 6 to 8, somewhere around there, I can't quite remember, and I was getting ready to send one of my foster hamsters off to a new home, which was really great. So I was talking to his future adopter online. This was in the evening and Cream Puff had woken up, so I decided to try and clean her little habitrail ovos that were connected to her tank. I got distracted and I left one of the little doors open on the transport unit, and Cream Puff climbed out, and this tank was a good probably 5 feet high up off the floor on hardwood floor. There was hardwood underneath. She climbed out and I didn't realize it. I was at my computer typing and then I just heard this giant like splat on the floor, and it was the most horrifying feeling, and I knew immediately that it was Cream Puff. So I ran to look at her and she sort of like scurried under a little table. I managed to get her. I'm surprised she didn't run away and panic or anything, but I checked her over and oh my goodness, she was perfectly fine. I don't know how she managed to land on all 4 feet. It must have been an angel protecting her, but I seriously would probably have never forgiven myself if she got hurt from that incident because it was my fault. So thankfully that was the last time that I had ever forgotten like a cover or anything like that open, and I'm just so thankful none of my hamsters ever got injured because of my stupid mistakes. This is actually a reason why I really love just having one DIY cage or one large tank, is you don't have to worry about tubes and covers and all of that. It can be a huge responsibility to have to keep up with all of that. So kind of like the less cages you have attached, the better, and you just have to keep up with like their main cage. So that's kind of something I've learned over the years. I think those are all of the mistakes I can think of. I'm sure that I've made others, but those are like the major mistakes, and it just goes to show that nobody is perfect, and you know, nobody knows everything there is. There's always something to learn and something to research, and we're still learning about hamsters as it is, which is really great, and how to better suit their needs and what size of cage they thrive in and that sort of thing. So I hope you guys enjoyed this chatty video and maybe learned a little bit about what not to do if you have a hamster, but thank you so much for watching, and Thank you for sticking with my channel even through my sporadic uploads at the moment. I am doing my best. Anyways, I'll stop talking now. Thank you guys again so much for watching and have a wonderful week. Bye.